My name's Simon, I work at the Pirbright Institute, and I'm a scientist.
Hi, my name is Moiz, I'm a scientist at the Pirbright Institute.
Hi, my name is Emma, I work at the Pirbright Institute, and I'm a scientist.
Hi, my name is Amina, I work at the Pirbright Institute, and I'm a scientist.
I'm a research scientist, and I look at viruses that make animals sick. As viruses are always changing, we need to make sure that the tests we use are able to detect them. I help to improve these tests to make them work better and faster.
I work with viruses that actually infects pigs. So what I do is I have viruses, and then I add different colors to the viruses because they're so small, you can't see them with your eyes, and that's why I have to add colors to it. And then I have a look at the viruses under the microscope.
So at the Institute, my job is to genetically engineer mosquitoes. And what that means is that I get to change this thing inside of them, this thing called DNA, which is essentially their code for their entire life. And I can play around with this DNA. I can change the DNA to make these mosquitoes green or red or blue. And if I change enough of it, I can stop the mosquitoes from transmitting really dangerous diseases like malaria or dengue virus. So I'm a PhD student, and what that means is that I get 3 to 4 years to play around in the lab, ask loads of questions, and I actually get paid for it.
My job at the Pirbright Institute is a senior technician. I work within a laboratory that gets samples from animals from all over the world, and it's my job to work out if the animals have a virus, and if they do, what virus is making them ill.
My favourite thing about being a scientist is that there's a lot of variety to my work, so I'm never doing the same thing 2 days in a row. I also get to use lots of new machines and technologies which look like they belong in a science fiction film.
So my favourite thing about being a scientist is that I get to do lots of experiments, and then I get to find out how different viruses are actually behaving in different animals.
So my favorite thing about being a scientist is that I get to hang around with other scientists, and we get to nerd out about all things related to DNA, mosquitoes, and it's a lot of fun.
My favorite thing about being a scientist is that it is my job to ask a lot of questions. I'm quite a curious person naturally, so being in science enables me to ask questions that no one has ever asked before and run experiments to find out the answers. I love that as a scientist, you're often the first person to find something new out.
So one of the skills I need to be a good scientist is I need to be able to ask all sorts of questions. And I don't really want to worry about whether this question is stupid or weird, as long as I have a method of finding out the answer. And one method is to design an experiment. So one of the other skills I need after I design my experiment is to actually make predictions about the outcome of that experiment. One really cool experiment that I can actually design is to inject DNA into my mosquitoes. The kind of DNA that I predict is going to turn it into a red color. And I can do an experiment and find out if that actually is the case.
So as a scientist, you need a lot of different skills. So as I do a number of experiments, I have to make sure that I am actually setting up my experiments properly, and I'm organized, and I'm doing them in the correct way. So another important skill as a scientist one should have is the ability to observe the small changes you can see within an experiment and to measure the outcome of that particular experiment.
As a scientist, I need a number of different skills, as there are several steps to my work. The experiments that I set up produce a large amount of data, and I have to make sure that it's all recorded accurately. Sometimes we look for small differences in the data, so it's important that I carefully record everything. Another skill that I need as a scientist is the ability to evaluate the data that I've collected. This is very important to discover what went right, but also what went wrong. If something goes wrong, then I become a detective to work out exactly why it happened and what I can do next time to fix it.
So another skill I need to be a good scientist is to be able to communicate my results. And I actually quite really like that. I can do an experiment, find out the data from that experiment, and communicate it to my supervisors, talk to my fellow scientists about it, receive some of their critique. But also, I like communicating this result to my dad and to my mom over the dinner table.
One of the cool things I've done as a scientist is being one of the last people to work with a virus that is no longer on the planet. This is the first case of an animal virus that has been wiped out, and this is because of the hard work of vets and scientists around the world.
So the coolest thing I have done as a scientist is to share my work with other scientists around the world. So you get an opportunity to travel around the world and share your work with other people as well.
Yeah. So the coolest thing I've ever done as a scientist is that I actually designed this type of bacteria which can live inside of your intestines and monitor your health and actually tell you if you're about to get sick.
The coolest thing that I've got to do as a scientist is to travel to many different countries around the world. A lot of the viruses that I work on are not found in the UK, and therefore some of the science that I've done has involved traveling to laboratories and farms in other countries such as Kenya and Tanzania.
One of my favourite science facts is that while adults have 206 bones, babies have over 300. This is because, later in life, some of these extra bones join together to make larger bones.
So, my favorite science fact is the fact that if I took all the DNA inside of your body and stretched it out as long as possible, it would be so long that it could go across the entire solar system twice.
My favorite science fact is that viruses are so small that if you lined up 100,000 next to each other, it would only measure about a centimeter.
As a scientist, I'd like my work to make a difference and help future scientists learn more about the animal viruses that we have on this planet.
So as a scientist, I would like to help make a vaccine against the virus I'm working so that the animals don't get sick anymore with this virus.
So the thing I want to achieve as a scientist, well, there's actually two. I want to eliminate malaria, which is a really horrible disease. But more importantly, I just want to have fun.
As a scientist, it's my aim to contribute towards controlling animal diseases around the world. Being part of a team that detects these viruses provides important information to be able to do this.
I hope that you found this interesting and it's helped you to learn a little bit more about what a scientist does.
Being a scientist is an incredibly varied and exciting career. There are so many different types of jobs in science that you can do, and mine has allowed me to work with animals and people all over the world.
So I hope you have realized after watching this that how cool it is to be a scientist.
So what I want you guys to take away from this video is that science is actually a lot of fun. And all kinds of people actually work in science, like someone from me who's from Pakistan, or anyone else from all across the world.